The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 4th chapter, text number 11, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 1st of June 1974 in Geneva, Switzerland.
Jirathaman Prabhupadanti, Tams Tasiva Bhajamaham, Mamo Vatmanu Vatanti, Manushya Apartha Sarvasa. We are continuing from yesterday's subject matter, how one can become purified and go back to home, back to God. Here, the second line of this verse is very important. It is said, Mamo Bhagavanu Vartanti Manushya Partha Sarvasya. All human being is searching after me. As we have explained yesterday, Krishna means Sat-Chit Ananda Vigraha, the transcendental form of eternity, knowledge and blissfulness. In the Vedanta Sutra, the summarized philosophy of Vedic knowledge, it is said, Ānandamaya Abhyāsāt, the spirit soul by nature is jubilant. So, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, He is supreme living being, and we are also living being, but we are not the supreme. Try to find out this difference. But both of us, we are of the same quality, that means jubilant. So, our present position being materially contracted, just like a man in his healthy condition, he is happy, but in his diseased condition, he is not happy. Similarly, we being part and parcel of the Supreme, we are naturally jubilant, but on account of being contracted in material nature, we are morose. In the Upanishad, the Vedas, it is said that the nitya nityana chetana chetanana, the God is the chief of the living being. He is the chief of the persons. He is the chief of knowledge. In this way, He is described. Just like we can find out amongst us, one is more intelligent, more in knowledge. In this way, you search out God means the most intelligent, the full of knowledge, full of opulence, everything full. Now Krishna says, in the last stanza, Madhavam Agata. Madhavam means my nature. So Krishna's nature, you'll find always Krishna. He is enjoying with his flute and his associates, his consort, Radharani, and the gopis. You'll never find Krishna in morose condition. He is in jubilation, always. And because we are also part and parcel of Krishna, we have got the propensity to dance with young girls or enjoy the company of the young girls. That propensity is not unnatural. It is natural, jubilation. But because it is in material contact, we cannot enjoy it fully. There are so many inabilities. Those who have seen our temple, we were seeing Radha and Krishna in jubilation. They are along with the gopis playing the flute and many musical instruments, dancing. That is the definition given in the Vedanta Sutra. Ānandamaya Abhyāsa means by nature jubilant. There is no moroseness, there is no unhappiness. That is the kingdom of God. Now Krishna says, Jidathamam Pradadanti. According to the degree of surrender, one comes nearer and nearer. Krishna is manifested in three features, namely Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavaniti Sandas. Means he is revealed as impersonal Brahma, as localized Paramatma or the Super Soul, or as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. There are three different types of transcendentalism. They are called the Jnanis, the Yogis, and the Bhaktas. Jnanis mean those who are trying to understand the absolute truth in impersonal feature, Brahma Jyoti. The Jnanis means those who are mental speculators, philosophers, neti-neti. They are trying to understand the absolute truth by dint of their limited knowledge. They are called Jnanis. And the Yogis, the mystics, they are trying to find out the Supreme Personality of Godhead within the heart, because the Lord is situated in everyone's heart as Super Soul. In the Vedic literature, it is said that dhyanavastita tadgatena manasa pashyantiyam yogivam. Yogi, mystic, they are meditating and trying to find out the Supreme Personality of Godhead or the Super Soul, Paramatma, within the heart. And the bhaktas or the devotees, they are directly contacting the Supreme Personality of Godhead face to face. Just like Krishna appeared and the bhaktas met him face to face, not everyone could understand that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. But bhaktas could understand. That is Vrindavan Leela first time. Vrindavan Leela, Krishna manifests just to attract us that how you can meet the Supreme Personality of Godhead face to face, just like we are meeting in this meeting face to face. Similarly, you can also meet the Supreme Personality of Godhead face to face, but you have to be qualified for that purpose. If you want to understand Krishna in his impersonal Brahma feature, there is this part. I'll explain that. The Brahma feature is impersonal. Just like try to understand that there is sun, the sun glow, and within the sun glow there is the sun deity, and outside the sun glow there is sunshine. All of them are light. They, within the sun glow there is light, and in the outside the sun glow there is light, and the sunshine is also light. But still there are differences. Another example is, just like if you try to observe a mountain from distant place, it will appear as hazy cloud. And if you go still nearer, you will find something greenish rock. The subject of observation is the same thing, but you are looking in different way on account of your different angle of vision. Similarly, if you actually enter the mountain, you will find there are many trees, many houses, many animals, many men. It is full of varieties. Similarly, the absolute truth, object of vision, is one. But according to your angle of vision, sometimes you are seeing it is hazy cloud, sometimes as greenish mountain, and when you actually in that place, you see varieties of living entities, trees and houses, everything there. Similarly, those who are trying to understand the absolute truth by dint of his limited knowledge, they realize impersonal Brahma. Here Krishna says, Momo Bhatmanu Bhattante Manusha. Everyone means those who are actually seeking after God realization. They are following the same path, but on account of their distance of vision, they are realizing the absolute truth in different way. But all of them are beyond this material world. That I have already explained yesterday. Tapasa apurta, bahava tapasa apurta, madhava marga, bahava jnana tapasa, bahava jnana tapasa apurta, madhava marga. The process of going to the spiritual world is knowledge and austerity. That is for everyone. Either he is jnani, yogi or bhakta. But in going to the spiritual platform, there are differences according to the angle of vision. The risk of impersonal realization is that because in the impersonal feature you cannot enjoy that blissfulness eternally. Therefore, mostly, they come back again into the material world. Because by nature, we are jubilant. In the impersonal feature of Brahma Jyoti, we cannot enjoy life. Therefore, again we come back to this material enjoyment. Just like by an aeroplane, you want to go higher and higher. But if you don't get a shelter in another planet, you'll have to come back again to this planet. It is stated in the Vedic literature. Arucha kuchena param padam tataha patanti adha hana vitajusmadam. Unless you become elevated to the position of serving the Supreme Personality of Godhead face to face, simply by impersonal Brahma realization, you cannot become happy. Therefore, for enjoyment with variety, the varieties of enjoyment, to come down again to the material world. We have seen it practically, many big sannyasis and transcendentalists, they give up this world as mithya or false and take to sannyas. But after some time, again they come back to this material world for executing philanthropic activities like opening hospitals or opening schools and other philanthropic activities. It so happens because they cannot fully realize the absolute truth as the Supreme Person. They again come to these material persons. Therefore, in the Bhagavad Gita, you'll find Krishna says, Bahunam Janmanam Ante Jnanavan Mana Prapadate, which means, after many, many births, the jnanis, after speculative knowledge, when actually they come to the platform of knowledge, they surrender unto me, or they understand the Supreme Personality of God. The next line is, Vasudeva Sarvamiti, Samahatma Sudullam. One who can understand Krishna, whose another name is Vasudeva. So, he is everything. He is the origin of everything. One who can understand, he is supposed to be Mahatma, the liberated soul, or the great soul. Mahatma. Maha means great. Atma means soul. But, so Mahatma Sudullam. It is very difficult to find out such Mahatma. So, the Krishna devotees who are engaged in this missionary activity, Krishna consciousness movement, they are not ordinary persons. They are Mahatma, but very rarely to be found. Sa Mahatma Sudurlava. So, although everyone is searching after Krishna, either in impersonal Brahma or localized Paramatma, the person who has understood Krishna, the Supreme Person, he is the greatest, the successful man within this world. In another place, Krishna said, Bhaktanam Abhijanati Javan Jasyami Tattva. Krishna never says that by mental speculation or yogi mystic practice one can understand the supreme law. Never says. It is clearly said that Bhaktanam Abhijanati Javan Jasyami Tattva. Tattva means in truth. To understand Krishna in truth, that requires bhakti or bhakti yoga, not the jnana yoga, karma yoga, hatha yoga or any other yoga system. By other yoga system, like jnana yoga, karma yoga, hatha yoga, you can understand Krishna partially. As I have explained, that somebody is seeing the mountain as heavy cloud and somebody is seeing as greenish something. And somebody is saying, actually the mountain with all varieties. So, without bhakti yoga, realization of the absolute truth is partial. In another place, Krishna says, yoginamati sarvesa madgata antaratmana sadhyavan bhajati dhumam sami yukta matu mama. He clearly says that out of the many varieties of yogis, one yogi or the bhakta yogi who is always thinking of me within his heart, he is first class. So this Krishna consciousness movement is teaching everyone to become the first class yogi. This movement is giving everyone the chance of chanting this Hare Krishna mantra, which means always thinking of Krishna. As soon as you chant Hare Krishna, and if you hear the chanting process is, you chant and hear, then immediately you become in the samadhi state, absorbed in Krishna. This is not our manufactured way. It is ours, authorized by the Vedic scripture. Therefore, our request is that if you want to become first-class yogi, according to the authorized statement of Vedas, then you take to this Mahamantra, chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. The chanting, the purpose of chanting is that it is adoration. Hare, Hare means addressing the energy of Krishna. The energy is called Hara. Krishna is called Hari, and his energy is called Hara or Radha. Krishna, Radha, or Hari, Hara. So, the form of addressing is Hari. There are those who know Sanskrit. There is, the example is just like Lata. Lata word. The note of address is Late. Similarly, Hara is the word and the note of address is Hare. So the request is, O the energy of Krishna, O Lord Krishna, please accept me in your service. Without going through the energy of Krishna, nobody can approach Krishna. In the Bhagavad Gita, it is said, Mahatmanastuman Pratha, Daivi Prakriti Masrita. Those who are Mahatmas, actually, after many, many life cultivation of knowledge, when one becomes fully cognizant of Krishna's position, he surrenders. Some Mahatma Sudurlabha. So, that is also explained. Mahatma Rasumam Klaatva, Daivi Prakriti Masrita. Those who are Mahatma, they are taking shelter of the superior energy, Daivi Prakriti. Therefore, we worship Krishna not alone. Krishna with Radharani. You have seen the picture, Krishna is standing with Radharani. So, that is full realization of the absolute truth. Without energy, simply energetic Krishna, that is not full realization. So, all the Vaishnavas, they worship the absolute truth, personality of Godhead, with the energy. Just like there are many devotees, Sita, they worship Mother Sita and Rama. There are other Vaishnavas who worship Lakshmi Narayan. Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune, and Narayan. In this way, we Gaudiya Vaishnava, we worship Radha and Krishna. So, in this way, the process of approaching the Absolute Truth is a one straight line, but it is a matter of progress. One who has progressed 100 steps, another has progressed 1,000 steps, another has progressed many other more steps. But the aim is the same, Krishna, anyone. Anyone in transcendental life, they are aiming at Krishna. This can be understood in another way. Just as every one of us, we love our body. Or I love your body. But what is the reason? The reason is because the spirit soul is there. Nobody loves a body, either his own body or other's body, when it is dead. Therefore the conclusion is that every one of us, we love our body because the spirit soul is there. Therefore the conclusion is that I love myself or yourself, the spirit soul. Then the next question will be that why one should love the spirit soul? The spirit soul is love because it is part and parcel of Krishna. Therefore ultimate goal is Krishna. We do not know that. Therefore we sometimes love the body or sometimes love the mind or sometimes love the soul or in this way. But the ultimate aim is to love Krishna. That is our natural instinct.